So Ubiquiti was really nice and made it so simple. They just screw it in and seal it up with a little bit of electrical tape or some weatherproof putty, and you're ready to go. You don't have to worry about connectors or coax or messing with it. You don't have to worry about loss. It's very simple. There's on the bullets, there's the weatherproof hole to feed the Cat 5 through, and you can unscrew the cap. And just a standard Ethernet connection inside of there also. So very simple. Same thing with the integrator here. This is just a grid design. This is one of the larger ones. It's got two long brackets on it. The hole is on the bottom for the Cat 5 feed through. And same thing, this is just the 5.8 gigahertz head. This is just 2.4. You got power, RAM, and then the four LEDs. This one here, the air grid, is a single polar antenna, so it's either vertical or horizontal, depending on how you got it set up. Setting up in this mode here is the vertical mode. The nano bridge is a dual polarity, so it actually has both a vertical and horizontal antenna built inside of it. So it's dual polarity, a little bit more throughput and a little bit better reliability on it. That's why I like the Ubiquiti here. They're pretty much all standard, very simple to use. Web graphic GUI would be a good program and everything. And compared to the standard mesh setups that people are deploying now and setting up now, you don't have to worry about messing with firmware, you don't have to change a crystal and go on with frequencies. You don't have to worry about an outdoor box, you don't have to worry about finding power to get to it. These have a power over Ethernet, which sends 24 volts up to the antenna with the included power adapter. Sends right up the extra 4 spare wires inside the Cat 5 cable. So power over Ethernet is very simple, no extra cables to mess with. You don't have to worry about adapters, connectors, sealing it up. You just pop these on, throw them up on a tower on a hilltop, point them, and you know, they get the LEDs on it right there to get a basic rating. You can get a better rating by looking at the web GUI. But it's very simple compared to the WRT54Gs. Not much to have to mess around with. Stick it up and it gets the job done.
That's
brilliant.
Really nice.
Screws right on the bottom.
And
make another
powerful Ethernet. It'll let you know that 15 decibels. Yeah, so like 6 foot basically. It's like 5.5, almost 6 foot. The 15 decibel antenna. I bought one for an apartment complex. It's funny because like they're literally the size of your height. They're sometimes a little bit taller than you.
POE is usually 4 to 6.
Really?
Yeah. Because
of
telecom.
Yeah. Well, the IEEE standard is 48.
Yeah, 48.
But they have all those broken standards. I think Ubiquiti has a 12-volt and a 24-volt adapters, depending on their...
So they have their own PoE standard.
I wouldn't say it's standard. It's just their own
PoE non-standard.
Their own voltage they throw on the pins. That's what it comes down to.
So you can't
just
plug into it. Well, PoE's not usually used on an uplink device anyways, is it?
It's basically they use two heads for right. that for power.
But POE's usually used at the terminal side, not the WAN side, which is what that would be.
You need both, really. I mean, you need the power source and the
right. But I'm saying that it's usually like a because that would be an uplink connection. I mean, that would be I forget the technical term for.
Oh, kind of like a loop, so that it would keep relaying.
Yeah, what I'm saying is that's a the Ubiquiti is a router device.
Yeah.
And normally router devices don't receive power over the internet; they give it. That's how I've seen it used. Your phone or whatever thing that plugs into the router.
Ubiquiti's only receive it, they don't give it.
Exactly, they work kind of opposite of how PoE usually works, is what I'm saying.
Not really. I mean, you basically have your switches that send out power. You usually have your PoE switches or injectors.
Right, that's what I'm saying, the switches send out power. But do they send it out to uplink devices?
Yeah, like those, your phone.
Oh, they can? Yeah, well, phone's not an uplink device, so it's a...
It's receives, yeah.
It's a receive device.
Just like those Ubiquiti's, though. Those are Ubiquiti's receive only.
Oh, I thought they worked as an... Oh.
No, basically, the part that he neglected in that is that generally
you can't plug your computer directly into the Ubiquiti?
No, there's no power coming from the Ubiquiti. Basically, the Ubiquiti takes in the power source and then generally send you an injector.
Do you have to plug it into some kind of switch?
Yeah, so wherever that Ethernet cable comes from has to have an injector at the other end. So you basically have a 12 or 24 volt injector that basically just doesn't
give it the power. But I mean, other than that, it still works like a. It's still cable to cable without a switch in between.
Yeah. So you have one cable that has that voltage.
Right. If you were going to plug it into a router, you'd have to use the uplink port. You have to plug into the uplink port.
If you would plug it, let's say you have a router that doesn't have power over Ethernet on it.
Right.
The way to get that to work is basically you take that one port of that router,
right,
and then you plug it into
the power injector. But you have to use the uplink port, is what I'm saying. You can't just use a regular port.
You can use any port, yeah, as long as you want something to go to it.
You know, okay, guys, that's for, I want to thank Ken for bringing
anything
all
else? Any other questions?
That's great.
Thank you.
I need more power.
Well, it'll be exciting to see this thing up.
One thing, yes. You can find the WP54 GLs on eBay, brand new, for $45. Yeah.
Shipped. Nice.
Yeah. Brand new.
Well,
that's where I got mine, on eBay. I got mine on Amazon.
This guy had already sold 179 of them, so he's probably got at least one.
Yeah, probably.
Well, if I hear that any of the TV stations up in Cleveland are selling off old live trucks, I'll let you know. They're actually moving away from them.
There are a couple of, for the ham radio guys, there are a couple of questionable actions about using some of this stuff, because, you know, like they, advertisement said, well, you know, you can use your email, or you can get an email or something, but to get into an email account, you need a password. Passwords are going to be encrypted.
Right.
According to FCC regulations for the ham radio guys, we aren't allowed to.
You aren't allowed to put any encryption over 90, yeah. Over section 97.
So you don't want to go out to like YouTube and live stream a music video across it, because you're actually, now are we breaking the law?
No, it depends. Just keep your power down to part 15 and you're fine.
Yeah, yeah, that's the power down to part 15.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Yep.
Okay. Thank you very much.